Okay, good morning students. Today our topic is about the modes of reproduction. In the last class we have covered about the asexual mode of reproduction. Okay, now in this class we will be studying about the sexual mode of reproduction. In the sexual mode of reproduction, if you look into this chart where I have shown that there are two types of in the flow chart, you can see that the modes of reproduction, there are two types, that is asexual reproduction and second one is sexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction ke do types hote hain. The first one is vegetative reproduction and the second one is apomixis. Okay, in sexual reproduction again there are two types, that is autogamy and the second one is allogamy. Autogamy ko hum self pollination bhi kehte hain, allogamy ko hum cross pollination bhi kehte hain. अब हम डिटेल में पढ़ेंगे कि व्हाट इज ऑटोगेमी एंड व्हाट इज एलोगेमी और व्हाट इज एक्चुअली सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन, व्हाट हैपेंस इन द सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन, दैट इज वी आर स्टडिंग इन रेफरिंग टू प्लांट्स, टू द फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स. इफ वी सी दैट ओके, इफ वी सी व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन, then you can see here reproduction is the development of new individuals, that is the progeny, from their existing ones, that is parents. Okay, jo progeny parents se develop hoti hain unhe hum kehte hain, use hum kehte hain reproduction. Okay, it is the process of development of new individuals from their pre existing ones, that is from the parents. The manner in which they originate is called as the modes of reproduction. Okay, जो मैनर होता है उसे हम कहते हैं मोड्स ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन, जो कि अगेन दो प्रकार में डिवाइड किया गया है. द वेजिटेटिव पार्ट्स ऑफ द प्लांट्स आर द रूट, स्टेम्स एंड लीव्स. एक प्लांट के वेजिटेटिव पार्ट्स कौन कौन से होते हैं? द रूट, स्टेम्स एंड लीव्स. रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट्स ऑफ द प्लांट आर द फ्लावर्स. रिप्रोडक्टिव
फ्लावर्स. The reproductive parts of the plants are the flowers. We will study this, the parts or the structure of the flower, in detail in the next slides. In plants there are two main types of reproduction, that we have already seen that there are two types of reproduction, that is sexual reproduction and the other one is asexual reproduction. The sexual reproduction takes place in the higher organisms like humans, whereas the asexual mode of reproduction mainly takes place in the lower organisms, and it also takes place in the plants. There are asexual reproduction and the sexual reproduction. Okay, so the two modes of reproduction are these two types. Now if we see what is the major difference between the sexual and the asexual reproduction, here I have shown you in this slide that the asexual reproduction is, it involves only one parent. In asexual, here if we are talking about asexual reproduction, that can be an apomixis or it can be a vegetative reproduction. Okay, so vegetative propagation, whenever it happens, we do it with the runners, so stolons, suckers, bulbs, that we have already seen in the last class. These are the underground stems. So these are the underground parts of the plant. So it involves only one plant is involved in this type of reproduction. So the progenies which are produced through the asexual reproduction, they are mainly similar to that of the parents. Okay, they are mostly similar to that of the parents, and the offsprings, they are genetically identical to the parent. The offsprings or the progeny that are being produced, they are similar to the parent. So there are basically two modes of reproduction. First is asexual reproduction and the sexual reproduction. Now we will see what is the major difference between the sexual reproduction and asexual reproduction. Okay, it involves only one parent. So one parent is involved in the asexual reproduction, whereas in the sexual reproduction it involves two parents. That is, the proper embryo is formed. That is, there is a fusion of the male and the female gametes. Asexual reproduction, offsprings are genetically identical to the parent, because here you see that there is only one parent is involved in the reproduction. So the offspring or the progeny which is being produced, it will be genetically similar to that of the parent. Whereas in the sexual reproduction, offsprings are genetic mix of both the parents. They are, that is, the both, there is a fusion of the male eggs and the female sperm. So females eggs and the male sperm, sorry. So it involves the genetic mix. So there is a lot of genetic variation which is found in the progeny in case of sexual reproduction. In asexual reproduction, again, it involves regular body cells. So that regular body cells are involved in the asexual reproduction, whereas in the sexual reproduction, the sex cells, specialized sex cells are involved in sexual reproduction. This is a very important point. And in case of asexual reproduction, it is very quick, whereas the sexual reproduction, it takes time. Again, we will revise here. Various asexual modes of reproduction can be, so the ways of the plants to reproduce can be from spores, from suckers, from underground stems, or from stem cuttings, or from leaves, or it can be from seeds. So these are the various modes of reproduction, or the vegetative modes of reproduction that you can see in the plants. Now we will move on to today's main topic, that is sexual reproduction. Now, actually, what is sexual reproduction? Here we will see it requires two parents, that is male and the female one. So the egg, so there is a fusion of egg and the sperm in order to form the zygote. So this type of reproduction is called as the sexual reproduction. So again, we will say that it is the fusion of male and the female gametes to form the zygote. The sperm from the male and egg from the female, they join to form the zygote and that zygote differentiates into an entirely new organisms. Offsprings are different from the parent organisms. So yahan pe kya hota hai, sexual reproduction mein the offsprings which are produced, they are different from that of the parents, because there is the proper fusion is taking place here. This process creates genetic variability makeup, which is driving force behind the evolution. So whatever the driving force is behind the evolution is due to the sexual type of reproduction, because in this type of reproduction, the genetic variation is created. Okay. Whereas in asexual reproduction, there is no much genetic variation, or we can say that all the progenies are of the same genetic constitution as that of the parents, because only one parent is involved there. Here we will see that the sexual reproduction, it produces a greater chance of variation within a species than asexual reproduction would. So as we all know that it creates a genetic variation, so it produces a greater chance of variation within the species. Ek hi species ke andar bahut sara humko variation milega. Okay. In as compared to that of the other mode of reproduction, this variation improves the chance that the species will adapt to his environment and survive. Okay, so jab bhi genetic variation create hoga, then the plants will have the different amount of immunity, we can say, or different amount of adaptation capability to the various environment, and then they will survive. Some of the plants will survive, some of the plants will not survive. So again, here we will see it involves male and the female parts of the flower. So in sexual reproduction, now we will see what are the various four stages of sexual reproduction. First is pollination, the second one is fertilization, fruit and the seed dispersal, and the last one is germination. Now we will see what is the floral structure of a plant. Now, because as we have seen that it is the main flower, is the main reproductive part of a flower, part of a plant. So we should know that what are the various reproductive parts of a flower. First is reproductive parts are stamens. Stamens are the male organs, whereas carpels are the female organs. Stamens ke andar kya kya hote hain? If we dissect the stamen, then the structure of the stamen can be anther, and this long thing is this called as filament. Whereas if we see the structure of a carpel, it has a stigma. This long tube-like structure is called as style. And this one is the ovary wall, and inside the ovary wall there are ovules. So this is the structure of the stamen, this is the structure of a carpel. Okay, you should know all these things. Structure of the flower, again you will see this is called as the stalk, this is called as a stalk, these are called as sepals with the green structures which are present. These are called as the septicle, this one is the nectary. Now this part is the carpel, which is the female reproductive organ. So carpel has three structures, that is style, stigma and ovary, whereas anthers and filaments together, they are called as stamens, and this one is called as petals. Petals are the main the portion, red color or pink color petals you see in the flower. Now we will study in the detail. Flowers are the reproductive parts of the plant. As we all know, stamen is the male reproductive part. So stamen is the male reproductive part, whereas pistil is the female reproductive part. If it is asked, then what is the male reproductive part of the flower? Then stamen is the male reproductive part and pistil is the female reproductive part of the flower. Flowers which have only the stamens and only the pistils, they are called as unisexual flowers. Now you should also know that what are unisexual flowers and what are bisexual flowers. Unisexual flowers are those which have only the stamens or only the pistil. Means those flowers which have either only the male part or they have only the female part. Both male and the female parts are not present in one flower. That is called as unisexual flowers. Examples are like maize, papaya and cucumber. And bisexual flowers means those flowers which have both the male and the female part, that is stamens and pistils, both are present in the same flower. That is called as bisexual flower. Bi means two, means both male and the female parts are present in the same flower. Examples of the bisexual flowers are rose, mustard, petunia, etc. The stamens has a filament and an anther. So the parts of the stamens are filament and anther. The anther contains pollen grains within which contains the male gametes. And the pistil, what are the parts of the pistil is style, stigma and ovary. The ovary contains the ovules. So ovules are inside the ovary, which contains the female gamete or the eggs. In sexual reproduction, the male and the female gamete, they fuse together to form a zygote. So male or female, both the parts are used in the sexual reproduction and they fuse together to form the zygote, which ultimately develops into a completely new organism or the new plant. Now we will study the second topic, that is pollination. Actually, what is pollination? Because this is also a mode of reproduction or which favors the reproduction. The transfer, so the pollination, the definition of pollination is the transfer of pollen grains from anther to the stigma of a flower is called as pollination. मतलब जो pollen grains होते हैं उनका transfer anther से stigma पे, okay? Of a flower is called, so of a flower means it can be on the same flower or it can be on the different flower. It is called as pollination. Pollen grains are transferred. So pollen grains can be transferred either by wind, water or insects. If the pollen grains land on the stigma of the same flower, अगर pollen grains सेम फ्लावर के ऊपर अगर वो पॉलिनेट होते हैं देन इट इज कॉल्ड एज सेल्फ पॉलिनेशन. सो सेल्फ पॉलिनेशन मींस ट्रांसफर ऑफ द पॉलन ग्रेन्स फ्रॉम द एंथर्स टू द स्टिग्मा ऑफ द सेम फ्लावर. सेम फ्लावर हियर इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. इट इज कॉल्ड एज सेल्फ पॉलिनेशन. वेर एज इफ द पॉलन ग्रेन्स ऑफ वन फ्लावर दे लैंड ऑन द स्टिग्मा ऑफ अनदर फ्लावर. ओके, इफ द पॉलन ग्रेन्स ऑफ वन फ्लावर दे लैंड ऑन टू द स्टिग्मा ऑफ अनदर फ्लावर देन इट इज कॉल्ड एज क्रॉस पॉलिनेशन. So this thing you should know, that what is pollination, what is the self pollination and what is the cross pollination. So cross pollination, there are different modes of cross pollination, like honeybees can also be one of the factors. Okay, or we will see like wind is a factor, then water is a factor, then even the animals. So the different type of, like if the pollination is taking place by honeybees, or then it is called as entomophily. If it is taking place by water, then it is called as hydrophily. If it is taking place by air, then it is called as anemophily. And if it is taking place by animals, like certain animals are also responsible for cross pollination, then it is called as zoophily. So pollination is the transfer. We can say it is a transfer of pollen grains from anther to a stigma. Pollination is usually carried out by insects such as bees, butterflies, wind and water. So there can be different modes of pollination. What are the different types of pollination? Self pollination and cross pollination. And types of flower, if we will see, there are two types of flowers, that is unisexual flowers and bisexual flowers. Unisexual flowers are those which have either the stamens or the pistils present on the same flower. Okay, they will have either pistil or stamens. And bisexual flowers, they will have both male and the female, that is the pistils and the stamens present on the same flower. That is called as bisexual flowers. Unisexual flowers, they contain either the male, again, for revision. Example of unisexual flowers are papaya and watermelon, okay? And the bisexual flowers, which contain both the stamens and the pistils, they are the bisexual flowers. They're present on the same flower. The example is hibiscus and mustard, okay? Reproductive parts, again, here I have shown you in the diagrammatic form, where stamen is the male floral organ. It contains anthers. Stamens ke andar kya hote hain? Anthers and filament. These are the parts of stamen. So anther is what? It is a part of the stamen that produces the pollen. It produces the pollen, okay, which are the main, which are transferred by the various modes. Filament is a stalk-like structure. Filament kya hota hai? It is a stalk-like subject here that holds the anther. Okay, anther ko hold karke rakhta hai. And pollen grain, they are the male gametophyte, which contains the male gametes. And pollen grain kya hote hai? They are the male gametophyte. Whereas if we see the female floral organs reproductive part, carpel and pistils, they are the female reproductive part. Ovary is an enlarged. What is an ovary? If it is asked in exam that what is ovary, since you know that inside the ovary there are ovules. Ovules are the female reproductive part. So ovary is an enlarged structure at the base. See, this is an enlarged structure at the base of the carpel or pistil where the ovules are located. Inside this, there are ovules. It will become the fruit after fertilization. So after the fertilization process, this ovules becomes the fruit. Ovules, they contains the female germ cells or the egg cells. The ovules ke andar kya hota hai? They are the female germ cells or the egg cells they contain. Seeds after fertilization, which develop into seeds after fertilization. Stigma is what? Is where pollen grains, pollen sticks. Okay, stigma is where the pollens, we dust the pollens. Actually, what happens in the this hybridization or pollination technique, we dust the pollens of the different flower into here. Okay, the pollen grains stick on this surface, on the stigma. And in this way, the pollination takes place. Style is what? It is the pollen tube which connects the stigma to the ovary. This is called style. It connects the stigma to the ovary. Okay, so this is very important. You should know that what are the male reproductive organs of a flower, what are the female reproductive organs of the flower. Now we will see what is the definition of self-pollination. Self-pollination is transfer of pollen grains within one flower. Means here the transfer of pollen grains, they see here. See here, the pollen located on the stamen moves onto the pistil of the same plant. Ek hi plant ke upar pollination ho raha hai. Means jo pollens hai, wo stamen se, they moves to the pistil here, pistil of the same plant. Means plant A and plant B here, ek hi plant mein ho raha hai. Two plants are not involved in self-pollination. Okay? So we can say it is a transfer of pollen grains within one flower. They are from the anthers. From where these pollen grains are getting transferred? From anthers to the stigma of the same flower. This thing is you have to remember. Cross-pollination is what? It is the transfer of pollen grains from the flower of one plant to the flower of a plant having the different genetic constitution. Here you see the two different flowers are involved. Pollen grains are transferred from one flower to another flower. Okay, so the two different genetic constitution is different of the two flowers. So the cross-pollination can be taken place by different modes. Like here you can see an example, honeybee is the example. Honeybee is also doing the pollination. It is transferring the pollen grains from one flower to the another. So it can be a one of the mode of reproduction. Here this will stop video. Again, you have to connect with me.